Welcome to the second video on the digestive tract. This is for enrichment purposes, and most information in here is not really relevant for exam purposes, but it might be of great benefit to know these things. Let's revise very quickly from the first lesson, the digestive tract. You'll notice there's the mouth at the top, then the esophagus, then the stomach, then the small intestine, then the large intestine, then the rectum, and then the anus. The digestive system has accessory digestive structures, that is the salivary glands, the gallbladder, the liver, and the pancreas, and all of these excrete enzymes and other juices that are important for digestion. The 6 steps of nutrition. Some books only include 5 because they don't include circulation. But let's go through them very quickly. Ingestion, that's putting the food in your mouth. Digestion, the breaking down of food into simple substances. Absorption is where the food is absorbed into the bloodstream. Circulation is the food being taken from the digestive tract to the cells. Assimilation is where the nutrients go into the cells. And elimination is where the waste gets eliminated. The digestive processes include mechanical digestion, that's the biting and chewing and so on forth, whereas chemical digestion is actual chemical reactions where enzymes break down food into simpler substances. Digestive tract health, for optimal health, you must choose good food, food that are healthy, good variety of food as well, food that are nutritious. For proper digestion of food and absorption of nutrients, you obviously need also the right choices because the body needs to make enzymes, etc. Otherwise, the body can't digest food properly. You need a good balance of your healthy gut flora. In other words, you need a lot of probiotics, your viruses and your bad bacteria, as well as your fungi in your gut must be under control. That's where the probiotics help. And the healthy elimination, you must not suffer from constipation. Some issues with the digestive system, look at it. You need to make sure you get healthy food. These are solutions then. You use balanced meals, have healthy probiotics, exercise, get rest, get sleep, drink clean water, and if you need a supplement, then use whole food supplements. Because unfortunately, many of the synthetic supplements tend to be harmful. This has been shown in research. Some people say, but they eat right. The quality of our food affects our health. Independent studies show that nutrient depletion in your food is happening. It's a reality. For example, in a serving of spinach, iron drop by 21%, vitamin A by 38%, vitamin C by 60%. In another study of 22,000 people, not even one of them got all 10 specific essential nutrients in their regular diet. They say they eat healthy, but when you look at the essential nutrients, these are nutrients your body can't make, you must get it from your food, then there was not even one person in this 22,000 that did get all 10 of these essential nutrients. Problems we have is that the food that we have contains toxins, like GMO foods, for example, tea can have pesticides in it, especially the tea bags. There's arsenic, cadmium, lead, acrylamide at high levels in nearly 80% of infant formula. That's shocking. But that's the reality. And UC Davis found 69% of imported olive oil to be fake or did not meet standards. Now, these are shocking things, and there are many other examples. Like honey in many countries is not really honey. What to look for if you want to choose a supplement? There are things you must look at. Because people are poisoning themselves, even some studies that show this. Make sure it's made from organic food, not from rocks and acetylene and petroleum and pond slime, synthetics or other non-food sources. Make sure it's non-GMO, because GMO foods often contain glyphosate and other toxins. Make sure there's a seal of approval or accountability, some of the third-party seal that says the supplement is great or healthy or that it's been tested. It must be made under pharmaceutical license. This guarantees that what's on the label is in the product. So often people buy products and it doesn't even contain what is on the label. A study done in Canada on herbal products showed that about 60% of herbal products that were tested did not contain the herb that was mentioned on the label. Also make sure the supplements are tested in humans, tested for bioavailability, and this doesn't really help. And make sure the company doesn't outsource its supplements, otherwise the company doesn't quality check, really. Does the company make its own supplements, in other words? Very important. And does it get tested? Also, are the supplements made in an FDA-approved facility? Be suspicious of companies that buy ingredients from brokers because they've got no control over this. There's a shocking example of aloe vera products in America that were tested and no aloe vera was found in the products. Why? Because people bought the ingredients from brokers. Make sure the company is a recognized scientific team or board, scientific staff. Also, surf the web to see if the company was ever sued for fraud, death, bribery, negative health side effects, and misrepresentation. Because if you want to put something in your mouth, you want to make sure that it's a healthy thing. You need probiotics, because probiotics are very important because it aids in digestion, it improves lactose intolerance, it inhibits growth of pathogenic bacteria and fungi, it also aids in absorption of minerals, it prevents diarrhea, it also produces beneficial substances such as enzymes and vitamin K. Some people that are like lactose intolerant might just be lacking probiotics because the probiotics actually produce lactase, which is the enzyme that digests lactose. And because of this, the factors that I mentioned here, the probiotics promote vibrant health in general. Also, they promote colon health, they help to detoxify the colon, and they also support healthy colon cells. They support immunity, so it naturally prevents infection, alleviates allergies, promotes the balanced immune system, which even regulates autoimmune issues. Some scientists actually say that up to 75% of allergies can be traced back to bad probiotics. Probiotics are the good bacteria, which you find in fermented food and yogurt with live cultures. There are many health issues linked to probiotics. Some experts link about 75% of all disease to gut health. And this list here is not a complete list, but it gives some idea of possible connections with probiotics. Do we need to supplement probiotics? Maybe, because there are so many factors that can harm your probiotics, like antibiotics, alcohol, dairy that contains hormones, diseases can do it, genetically modified organisms, if you eat food that's GMO, in other words. If you eat excessive red meat consumption, because in red meat is antibiotics. Conventionally farmed fish often also get antibiotics. Smoking can play a role, even lack of sleep and stress. Water contains chlorine, lack of fiber, not consuming prebiotics. Probiotics must at least comply with some of the following. You need a broad spectrum, because there are different types. Must be concentrated. And if you take something, be sure it contains living organisms. No artificial things in there, no preservatives. Must be from whole food. So it can be delivered in the intestines also. Must be protected against the stomach acid. Now there are different methods of doing that. Special capsules contain coatings that protect the bacteria against destruction by the stomach acid. Protein is also important for the gut because protein helps to make enzymes, helps with repair, with growth, with antibodies, to transport nutrients. It influences mechanical, hormonal, and neuroendocrine functions of the digestive system. Healthy elimination is important. You need fiber for that, and it helps you keep you regular. Fiber also has other functions in the body. For example, supports your health in terms of cholesterol, also into blood pressure and blood sugar and weight control, and it serves as a prebiotic as well. Garlic is a herb that's also important. In terms of your gut, it inhibits bacterial, fungal, and yeast growth. It also promotes normal cell growth and renewal in the digestive tract. It also removes parasites. Here are some herbs. Like I said in the first video as well, these herbs might be beneficial to help promote good digestive health. If you look after your digestive system, you will enjoy a healthier life. For more information, you can always contact me. There's my email address. There's also my Facebook page. So if you need advice on better health in terms of nutrition or the digestive tract specifically, you can contact me.